Students, in this class also I'll continue with the same chapter, that is chapter number 7, Indian Economy. And yes, our topic is characteristics of Indian economy as a developing economy. Now in this we have got 13 different headings, but before that let us go through the introduction, which says that no doubt there are some areas of Indian economy which were mentioned or which we discussed in our previous class, and obviously they indicate the lower economic development. India cannot be called a less developed nation, yes, because it has got certain areas of the economy that are progressing, and we will be studying about those different areas. And the very first one is growth rate. Now growth rate of our country, no doubt it increased in the beginning. Now we'll be studying about it in detail, that the growth rate of economy, which is measured by growth rate in national output year by year. Yes, it is calculated, it is measured. How? By knowing the growth rate in national output year by year. Year by year ko dekha jata hai, compare kiya jata hai, and wo increase hua hai, especially after LPG, that is liberalization, privatization and globalization. Now during the period between 1950-51 and 1990-91, the average annual growth rate was around 3.5%. However, after the period of economic reforms, LPG, in 1991, the average annual growth rate has remained above 6.8%. Jaise maine bola, increase hua hai in the beginning. And yes, this is important achievement for our country. But after 2012-13, the growth rate has slowed down. It has reduced in 2014-15. The average annual growth rate was less than 5%. And yes, ab fir baad mein thoda sa reduce ho gaya tha. The net national income at factor cost at constant prices are given to you people for different years. And over here for the year 1950-51, it was 269,724 crores. Now it also increased to 8,751,834 crores in the year 13-14. So we can say that it has grown, it has increased by 18 times. So obviously this shows that over here our country has progress. Now let us move on to the second one, which is changing share of various sectors in national income and employment. Now in this heading we will be studying about ki different years mein jo different hamare teen sectors hain unka jo share hai wo national income mein kitna raha hai. We will be studying this with the help of the table, students, and yes, the table is in front of you, which says that the agriculture sector in the year 1950-51, uska share jo national income mein tha, 1950-51 agriculture and allied activities was 53.1, then in 1990-91, it reduced to 29.6. 2000-2001, it was 22.3. And then in 2014-15, it further reduced to 17.6. In the same way, it is given for the rest also. So if we see na students, if we compare, to agriculture sector jo hai, उसका शेयर इन नेशनल इनकम जो है वो रिड्यूस हुआ है फ्रॉम 50-51 टू 2014-15. इफ वी कंपेयर 53.1 से वो रिड्यूस होकर 17.6 हुआ है. इंडस्ट्रियल सेक्टर इट हैज इंक्रीज्ड 16.6 से 29.7, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट फॉर द टू डिफरेंट ईयर्स 1950-51 से 2014-15 वाला. देन सर्विस इज ऑल्सो एक्सक्लूडिंग कंस्ट्रक्शन सेक्टर 30.3 से इंक्रीज होके 52.7 हुआ है. सो यस, दिस इज वॉट फाइनली वी ऑब्जर्व दैट द शेयर ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर इन नेशनल इनकम हैज डिक्लाइंड. यस, फाइनली वी कम टू द कंक्लूजन कि जो शेयर है एग्रीकल्चर का नेशनल इनकम में वो ओवर द ईयर्स इट हैज reduced, and that of rest of the two sectors, that is industrial sector and service sector, has increased. Now a little bit of different explanation in it. It says that yes, as a nation starts developing, the contribution of industrial sector and service sector in national income and employment increases. Now about employment also we will be talking in, obviously, in my next slide we will be seeing that. Now obviously it means that now the people jo log dependent the traditional sector, that is agriculture sector pe, now and with improvements in technology and capital formation, they got employment in relatively more productive sectors. Now because of more improvement, because of improvement in technology, because of improvement in capital formation, people started getting employment in relatively more productive sectors, and wo baki ke do sectors hai, industrial sector and service sector. Now India's service sector has started growing significantly after the reforms. Yes, wo hum logo ne study kiya hai. Now the following tables show the increasing share of industrial and service sector in national income and employment. Now national income you have already seen. Now we move on to the next topic, which will deal with, yes, that is the per capita income. Now isme hi hum logo ko employment ke bare mein bhi aayega. Now the per capita income of India at constant prices in 50-51 was 7114 rupees. Now it has also increased to rupees 39904 in 2013-14. So obviously again we can say that over here also the per capita income has increased approximately 5.6%, which is obviously a good increase. Now between the periods from 1950-51 to 1990-91, it increased by 1.6%, while after 1991 it increased by 5.5%. We observed that the share of agriculture in employment has declined over the years, and that of industrial and service sector has increased. Yes, the level of employment jo hamara next topic hai wo yahi cheez abhi aapko prove karke batayega. But let us go through about the different sectors before that. Level of employment mein very first sub heading is primary sector. We all know the primary sector, agriculture sector and allied activities. Apart from that, dairy farming and animal husbandry etc. are also included in it. The next is industrial sector. Industrial sector, yes, it includes manufacturing, construction, mining etc. Or in short, in other words, it includes all production activities. Production activities are included in industrial sector. Wo naam se hi malum pad jata hai. Industries means jahan pe production of different activities hota ho. Now let us move on to the third one, that is the service sector. It includes all the activities that are related to trade, banking, transport, health, education, broadcasting, hotel, etc. ये सब service sector में include होते हैं. Now finally, yes, you can see the table over here which shows us or which tells us that the share of agriculture sector has reduced. I'll directly go for the comparison. 1950-51 से लेके 2011-12, if you compare agriculture sector, industrial sector or service sector, you will find that yes, agriculture sector reduced. If you see, industrial sector increased, service sector has also increased. So yes, जो हम इतनी देर से read कर रहे थे, देख रहे थे, finally with the help of figures, it is explained to you people. Now let us move on to the next topic, which tells us about the improvement in basic, that is primary utilities, the primary requirements, facilities. वो जो है वो धीरे धीरे बहुत ज़्यादा इम्प्रूवमेंट उनमें आया है. इट हैज शोन सिग्निफिकेंट इम्प्रूवमेंट इन वेरियस डिफरेंट यूटिलिटीज इन अर्बन एरियाज, ऑल्सो इन रूरल एरियाज. ऐसा नहीं सिर्फ अर्बन एरिया में किया, रूरल एरियाज में भी प्रोग्रेस हुआ है, इम्प्रूवमेंट आया है इन बेसिक यूटिलिटीज लाइक इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, वाटर सप्लाई, रोड इरीगेशन एक्सेट्रा. नाउ अब हम इसमें ही डिफरेंट सब एडिंग्स के बारे में स्टडी करेंगे. द वेरी फर्स्ट वन इज इरीगेशन. नाउ इरीगेशन, लैंड अंडर इरीगेशन हैज इंक्रीज्ड. नाउ अगेन दिस इज एक्सप्लेन टू यू पीपल विद द हेल्प ऑफ फिगर्स, व्हिच सेज दैट इन 1950-51 ओनली 22.6 एम हेक्टर ऑफ लैंड अक्रॉस द कंट्री वॉज इरीगेटेड. Now it has increased to 63 m hectares in 2013-14. So finally we can conclude that 45% of total agricultural land has irrigation facilities in present time. So it says that irrigation facilities in our country has increased. In short, hum aise is subheading ko conclude kar sakte hain. Now let us move on to the next subheading in it, which says us about the literacy rate. Again, with the help of figures, this is explained. It says that the literacy rate, which was 18.33% in the year 1951, it rose, it increased to 73% in 2011. And obviously the source is very reliable, which is Economic Survey of 2013-14. Now let us know about the number of universities and colleges that have increased over the years. It is in the year 1950s, there were 20 universities and 500 colleges, which increased to 719 and 35,000 respectively by 2013-14. And obviously, it indicates, it shows the rise in higher education. And yes, if the literacy will increase in any country, obviously the country will develop, and hence it is part of characteristics of Indian economy as a developing economy. Now the next one is electricity. Bahut simple and easy figures mein yahan pe aapko bataya gaya that the electricity generation in our country has increased. Previously it was around 2300 megawatts. In the year 1950-51 it increased to 243,000 megawatts in the year 2011-12. Let us move on to the next subheading, which is road work. Now roads also increased. Now in present times, India belongs to the list of countries with longest road network, which is obviously a great achievement for our country. Now it has approximately 48.6 lakh kilometers of concrete roads today. That is pakka roads hamare country mein 48.6 lakh kilometers hai. Let us move on to the next one, that is railway. Indian railway network is the fourth largest today with a length of 65,000 kilometers. Obviously 65,000 kilometers to largest to hona hi chahiye, and it is fourth largest currently. Now let us move on to the concluding part of the chapter, which says that now India is a progressive country, developing country, and it's progressing fast. India जो है वो बहुत जल्दी जल्दी प्रोग्रेस कर रही है, एंड इज नाउ अ प्रेस्टीजियस इमर्जिंग कंट्री. पर कैपिटा कंजम्पशन ऑफ एसेंशियल कमोडिटीज हैज इंक्रीज्ड. यस, पर पर्सन पर हेड कंजम्पशन ऑफ एसेंशियल कमोडिटीज हैज इंक्रीज्ड, एंड देयर इज प्रोग्रेस इन द फील्ड ऑफ साइंस, रिसर्च, टेक्नोलॉजी डेवलपमेंट. नॉट ओनली दैट, but because of it and other factors, the average life expectancy of our country has also increased. Now, in International Comparison Program, in short, it is known as ICP, initiated, that is started by the World Bank in 2011, India was identified as, matlab, in the year 2011, India was identified as third largest country after US and China, while in 2005, India was at 10th position. So, yes, we can say that with the passage of time, our position is improving, it is increasing, and so, yes, our country is progressing. And with this, I am done with the chapter and obviously with the e-class also. So, take care of yourself, students. Thank you.